Thank you for joining us today, and let's enjoy this wonderful celebration of music. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This next piece is entitled Praise the Lord. It is by Florence Price, who is an African-American composer, and her music is actually receiving quite the renaissance now. This piece is unique and special because it's a piece that we had to do when singing stopped. We had to do it virtually. So we worked on it, had it ready to go, and never got a chance to sing in the same room together in the performance. So I decided to program this piece. So not only for me to get to hear it with human voices, but to be in the same space while we're making that music. So I hope you enjoy this beautiful piece called Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
life and breath, praise you, Lord. Cynthia Garn is our soloist, and she's also the soloist of the design of the previous piece. So all that have life and breath.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I thought this might happen. She forgot to plug it in last night.
Thank you.
this next piece, entitled How Long Ago, I'm speaking about it because one of our former choir members composed this piece. This was in the Branchtown Community Chorus for several years. He was one of my voice students, and now he's living in California doing amazing things, composing for orchestras and choruses all around the country. So we're going to do one of his pieces, How Long Ago. And the text is in the program, but Zachary Franklin is going to recite the text for you. And I really want you to pay close attention to the meaning of those words and the emotion behind them. And hopefully we can convey that message. Thank you.
You know, I was going to say, but unlike Mr. Picard, my heart, I do not have a doll. Come to me in the silence of the night. Come in the speaking silence of a dream. Come with soft, rounded cheeks and eyes as bright as sunlight on a stream. Come back in tears, O memory. Hope, love, a finished ease. O dream, how sweet, too sweet, too bittersweet, whose waking should have been in paradise, where souls brimful of love abide and meet, where thirsting, longing eyes watch the slow door that opening, letting in, lets out no more. Yet come to me in dreams, that I may live my very life again, though cold and dead. Come back to me in dreams that I may give pulse for pulse, breath for breath. Speak low, lean low, as long ago, my love. How long?
Thank you.
was the soloist who worked really, really hard here. She is suffering from laryngitis. So Cynthia Garn is stepping in her stead. But can we please give Jessica a round of applause? Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
afternoon's concert and also while we're setting up for our final piece. I want to take a moment to talk to all of you. As you saw, this was a free concert. And it's free because of the contributions that you give us as a free will donation every single performance. It allows us to have these kind of events, be able to support them, as well as supporting, and the most important part is supporting music scholarships. So I'm really excited to announce that in 2025, our choirs will be going on our third European concert tour. We will be going to Austria. And because of your generosity, especially today, you see where I'm going with this, we're able to reach our financial goals. So today is actually that what we call the soft kickoff, the official kickoff of the fundraising initiative, which is a two-year initiative, because you can, as you can imagine, a trip like that will cost over almost $100,000 to take everybody. So any funds that you give us today goes directly to supporting our students. It does not go towards administrative costs or anything like that. Those dollars, when a student comes to me and says, I can't afford to sing in choir this semester, or I can't go on tour because I don't have the money, I can then look at what we have in our available funds that we have raised. And I am so happy to say to this date, we have raised almost $30,000. That $30,000 did not come from me washing cars, selling candy, or anything. It came from you. Us doing what we do and what we love to do, and your generosity is what's making that possible. So if you choose to give today, please understand that your dollars will go directly to support our students. And if you write a check, please write it to Kellogg Community College, not to me, because I love to shop. So don't write it to me, write it to Kellogg Community College. Thank you very much for that. Now, that's that part of the process. Oh, you can give as you're exiting the doors. We will have people with very large baskets on either side. So Zach is up here for a really important reason. And it's because I can't do what I do without the wonderful people that I get to work with every single day. And often, they're not always acknowledged. And I want to take a moment to acknowledge some folks who have made my job so much easier. I am approaching my 20th year here at KCC, which I can't believe myself. So, so I have a wonderful group of folks. So I'm gonna ask a few people to come up. Where are my little cheat sheets? Okay. And they're probably gonna be mad that I'm calling them out like this. So the one person, I'm actually really thrilled to do this because she does this to me all the time. So I'm happy to call Diane Pridgen up to the front, please. Following her is Kathy Babbitt. Following Kathy Babbitt is Cynthia Garn. Following Cynthia Garn is Lucinda Wakeman. Will you guys please come up to the front for a moment? Thank you very much. And I also want to mention a person who I don't believe is here because I don't see her, but she has been my rock and my support since she first joined the Branch County Community Chorus. And if you are looking virtually, Martha, know that you're also up here as well. She does our social media, so that's just the kind of So you asked why I'm acknowledging these folks. So I'm going to take yours, Diane, and I'm going to read what they say. Diane and Kathy, I'm kind of grouping you together, and you know why. Okay, Diane and Kathy, besides the fact they're like sisters, this is called the Certificate of Appreciation Founders Award for Outstanding Service to the KCC Choral Union, proudly presented to Ms. Diane Pridgen and on Kathy Babbert. It says Kathy Babbert, on this 23rd day of April in the year of 2023. This award certificate is being given to Mrs. Diane Pridgen, or Kathy Babbert, for their continued support of the KCC Choral Program and dedication in service as founding members of the Branch County Community Chorus. So I want to take a moment to acknowledge you for that. Thank you. Next
I'm going to ask Lucinda and Cindy to come up. I kind of have two Cindys here. One is Lucinda, the other is Cynthia. Lucinda actually has been doing, all the Branch County folks are wearing these beautiful dresses. And it's thanks to Lucinda that we still have these dresses and they're still beautiful because she is like him, you know, in terms of making sure these things are returned and taken care of. And she has been with us for, I don't even know how many years at this point. 18 years. Think about that, 18 years. What a joy. Yes. And then, of course, I cannot forget. Come here, you. Come on. I mean, she's probably going to choke me after this concert. Yeah. But, oh my God, this woman here, I'm going to read you a plaque because I don't want to mess it up. It says, Certificate of Appreciation, Conductor's Choice Musicianship Award, proudly presented to Mrs. Cynthia Garn on this day, April 23rd of 2023. This award certificate is given to Mrs. Cynthia Garn in recognition of her outstanding musical contribution to the vocal choral areas at Kellogg Community College. If you don't know, and if you just think about today's concert, Cynthia played the xylophone, she sang, she leads sectionals, she's there. If I have to step out and her and Nancy have to do something, she is always there. And often, we don't recognize the people that really help our program remain strong. We think of the people who are leading it, right? It ain't us, y'all. It's all these folks that you see in this room, every single one of them. I could not do, Eric could not do, Christopher could not do what we do if we did not have these wonderful people. So let's take a moment and acknowledge all of these folks. Thank you. Now, the last person is certainly not the last, and the most important in my mind is my partner, Miss Nancy Brown. I know it's a task to try to find a path, but you can do it. You can go ahead and do the tour. Nancy and I once again, just like with Lucinda, I don't even know how long it's been that we've been collaborating together. But when I tell you, and if you heard the interview I did on WMUK, I tried to verbalize the significance of this woman. Nancy and I work so well together. She can anticipate what I am going to do. And that's a rarity when you work with folks. Even when she knows I'm a mess up, she can anticipate and save me from falling too deep, okay? And I am just so grateful, and I want to say publicly, how grateful and blessed I am to have you as a colleague, but more importantly, as a dear friend. So thank you so very much. Okay, so enough of the talking stuff. I had to get all that out, but I could not let this year go by. And I don't know if you heard, the reason being is this is the concert that I had envisioned so long for our 65th anniversary, which was in 2020, but we all know what happened. So I needed to take a moment, okay, to recognize these folks because they stuck with us. Look at this, y'all. Look at this. This is incredible. We are back. So thank you all. We're going to end the program with a piece called Oh Clap Your Hands by Ralph Vaughan Williams. And that piece is significant as well because the choir and the band, that band, we did it for the college's 50th anniversary. And we're going to do it again for you today. So I hope you enjoy it. You're going to get to hear all the glory of this magnificent Dobson organ. It is a Dobson, right, Dr. Wells?
Yes, it is a Dobson.
Okay, it is a Dobson. I have to double check. 4,500 pipes, y'all, so get ready, plus all this wonderful brass happening. So thank you very much, and enjoy the finale.
Oh, Thank you.